We value our content and our journalists, so to get access to all your local news updated 7 days a week, plus an edition of the Oban Times, subscribe today for as little as 56 pence per week. Already a subscriber? Log in here, subscribe now. The National Farmers Union of Scotland has contributed to a high-level conference at Westminster on the future of UK farming and the environment post-Brexit. Representing Nfus in a session on the competitiveness of UK agricultural products and future trading relationships with the EU and international partners last week, Director of Policy and Member Services Yanni Hall restated the importance of ensuring the negotiation and future domestic policies complement the vast variety in farming systems and environments across the UK. Addressing delegates last Tuesday morning, Mr. Hall outlined the value that agriculture in Scotland holds to the wider rural economy and socio-economic public benefits, and how post-Brexit governments should support farmers to deliver these benefits and allow food producers to deliver healthy, nutritious food to local populations. Mr. Hall and Political Affairs Manager Claire Slipper then returned to the House of Commons on Tuesday afternoon to meet with MPs from the different political parties, where it outlined its priorities for post-Brexit agricultural policy while its Brexit roadshow continued across Scotland. The union met key spokespeople from Scottish Labour, the SNP and the Liberal Democrats as part of their regular engagements in London. Mr. Hall said, "It is important that we work together with politicians during this period of change in order to come away from it with the best possible future for Scottish agriculture. Scottish farmers and crofters need long-term guarantees, not quick fixes, in order to properly run their businesses and continue to supply the high-quality produce that they are renowned for. It is not enough just to make it through Brexit. We need to ensure that these changes are ones which allow strengthening and growth within the industry, and that we continue to encourage ambition by delivering the right policies. This is why we are here, to ensure that, during these talks, Scottish agriculture is at the fore of any discussions on post-Brexit decisions."